Today's video is going to be talking about the concept of relentless repetition. For those of you guys that are new to the YouTube channel, my name is Cody, and in today's content, you're going to see a gameplay here in Mutt, and we're going to talk about some concepts that I think are really important to help you guys get a little bit better at Madden 17. These are some of the things that I've learned over the years of playing, and I think that this can definitely be helpful in several ways. You know, definitely more ways than one. But today's concept is relentless repetition. This is a phrase that I heard someone say, and it's really stuck with me. This idea of relentless repetition. So yesterday we talked about consistency. And basically one of the big time quotes we took away from was that successful people, great people, do consistently what average people do once in a while. And, you know, that's something that really, you know, has really stuck with me. And I want to kind of expand on what I mean by that. So we're going to play a little salary cap ranked here and show you a little bit about this. So the idea of relentless repetition is basically this: not only being consistent, but being relentlessly consistent, relentlessly repetitive. Every time I log on to Madden, this is one of the things that I've been starting to do, is I go to my Mutt Binder, and any players that are not using, I look to either sell them, place them in a pack, or do something to get rid of them, get them out of my binder, because I'm not using them. And it would be stupid to keep them in. Another thing that I do before I play any online game, and this is actually something new, is I will run... I will run a solo challenge, and in that solo challenge, what I'll do is I will run my base play over and over and over again, and I get that repetition over and over and over and over again, and I run my base scheme, my base play, if you will, and so that entails a couple of plays that I use from the gun tight, also a couple of goal line situational plays that I use. And what it does is it helps me get some reps against different types of defenses. So just to kind of get me in the process, in the habit, really in the rhythm of reading defenses, okay? So that's a couple things that I would recommend you guys doing is just playing a quick solo challenge game, practicing your setups. Solo challenge games don't take very long, but they can definitely be very, very helpful if you use them the right way. This guy is running a lot of inside zone. I talked a little bit about this in the video prior. One of the things I'm learning to do defensively this year is to basically chill out a little bit and call some two men under, let them kind of drive up the field on me the first drive or two, and then really kind of hone in from there, letting them have a couple of quick hits here and there, a couple good third down conversions is fine. What it allows me to do is it allows me to kind of fill them out. And I have also been a big proponent of setting up different defensive packages. So you'll see this year I go in and out of several different formations. The reason I'm doing that is because I find this year that basically this dime 1-4-6 is one of the best formations in the game for kind of just filling your opponent out and kind of seeing what they're going to do. And however, the nickel 3-3-5 odd has some zone pressures, can really is my bread and butter formation. When the time gets tough, you'll see me hop into the nickel 3-3-5 odd for sure. And the reason that I use that dime 1-4-6 though is because I want to kind of fill you out a little bit at the start of the game and then kind of go from there. Normally what you'll see is I'll run a lot of cover two man until I kind of start to see, okay, he's really kind of vulnerable to cover to maybe a zone blitz off this edge or that edge or whatever it may be. This guy's running a lot of inside zone, so that's why I'm kind of shifting, transitioning out of that nickel or out of that dime 1-4-6, hopping into this nickel 3-3-5 odd. I'm going to see if we can make a couple of adjustments here to lock this guy up. I kind of got a read on his basic thought process. He's looking to really hit me on those inside zones quite a bit. And so you'll see me adjust to that here to kind of go down, check down to that nickel 3-3-5 odd. Here in a key third down situation, I'm expecting Okay, so he goes five wide, so I'm expecting some quick slants here. We'll see what we get here. So there's some verticals, and that's a perfect example right there of learning the game. This year, if you have a guy that has high, is really tall in zone coverage, he plays pretty well, especially in those underneath yellow zones, and that's exactly what happened there. Leonard Floyd is really, really tall. I think he's like 6, I don't know, he's like 6'6 or 6'5, something like that. And anyway, so he's going to go right back to verticals. There, Von Bell's going to get in there. So high jump rating, height, and spec catch, those are three of the most important ratings if you're going to look for a zone coverage type of player. And I have all of those components in this one guy here. So those are some little bitty things, that little nuances that hopefully that can help you a little bit as you're kind of navigating this game. But I want to talk a little bit now about, you know, what to do once Madden 17 gets here. How do we kind of approach the game? And I think it's all about being consistent and being repetitive. So you're going to see a lot of similar things coming from me. I'm going to give you some content at the beginning of the year. We're going to talk about a couple of different things you can do to get a head start. Then we'll have a guide come out in which I will release the playbook that I'll be utilizing for the season, offense and defense. And then from there, what you're going to have is you're going to have a lot of different conceptual, situational type of teaching. We're going to say, okay, how to execute a 3rd and 2, how to execute a 4th and 4, different situations that you're going to face, you know, being in the game here. We're going to basically try to teach you how to face them. And I think it's going to be very, very helpful. We're going to talk a lot this year about reading the defense. It's something that we don't spend enough time talking about, and we're definitely going to talk about it this season. The reason we're going to talk about it is because it's really, really freaking important for several reasons. The reason that I'm going to talk about it at the beginning of the season is because it's really the foundation of any success you're going to have. You're going to have to be able to read and react. And really, this game is all about being able to read and react. It really is. It's all about flow. So if you ever look at a river, you'll notice that it kind of, if you look at it from an above the world perspective, you'll see that it kind of basically weaves and ends and outs around thing. It's not a straight line. Most rivers are circular. And the reason is because, part of the reason, I think, is because it's kind of a reflection on life. And Madden and sports and football and all that stuff, it all goes back to the same kind of concept here. We have to be able to adjust to what's going on. Right here, he's showing blitz. I could potentially probably get some pressure here from this far right side. So I'm going to look to those flats real quick. I get a nice read. We're able to keep ticking here. You know, this is why, you know, I think repetition is so important. I ran this playbook several times. He's showing blitz at a quarter. So this is pretty simple. What you want to do in that situation is, okay, tray open offset. I can hit an inside zone back cut. He's going to adjust here and it's fine. We're going to have a read I like. Give me a first down. We'll move the chains. Late in the clock, you don't want to get too crazy with your adjustments. So that's just one example of several things that we're going to be able to attack here. There's that nice little play I've been working on, that sync spot shake. Nice little cute little adjustment to some of the other things that we've been doing all season. And that's why you stay in the same playbook, guys. So I hope, one of the things I hope you take away out of this video that really is finding yourself basically a practice schedule or a repetition schedule, how to get in this game, really dig in and try to figure this stuff out. You know, what I'm really trying to get you guys to see here is that success does not happen overnight. It's relentless repetition over and over again, working the concepts. I've thrown drive out probably on my YouTube channel alone. I've probably thrown drive out, that little out route like that. I've probably thrown that route at least 500 times this season. On my YouTube channel alone, that doesn't count the practice reps. And that's how you get timing down. Consistency is how you get good execution. Relentless repetition is how you get good timing. Timing is everything, not just in Madden, but timing is essential. And so if you're going to be successful, you've got to have good timing. See right there, the pass rush, and you'll see this a lot of times. The one area I struggle a lot of times is when my timing gets thrown off, when the defense is able to basically make me hesitate. That's when it's very difficult for me to make the proper read. Okay, so what I'm trying to get you guys to see though is it's like that for all of us. This is everybody's Achilles heel when they're forced to basically, when they're knocked out of their rhythm. And I'm not going to try to say my what I have learned is to not try to basically always is to not try to basically be very good at adjusting your rhythm, but being able to be very good at controlling your rhythm based on what the defense is showing you. This guy's been running a lot of three high, quarter three deep, cover two sync type plays. So like he's leaving this out route wide open, so I can easily hit that route whenever I want. It's consistently open because of what his defense is doing. As opposed to maybe running the same play over and over again and trying to throw that route in 5 seconds or whatever. So know the timing of your patterns, know what plays are quick hits and quick plays, and I think that's so important, but it really comes down to that relentless repetition, getting into this game and repeating, getting reps over and over and over again in the same playbook, running the same plays, but really working, figuring out how to basically fit that little playbook into a scheme. That's something that is so important, and not just on the offense side of the ball, but on the defense. I mean, you saw again, timing is everything, and the only way you're going to be able to get better at timing is through repetition. If you ask anybody about any skill at all, whether it be speaking in front of people, whether it be losing weight, whether it be ball handling and basketball, it doesn't matter what it is, you have to get in the gym. There's no magic formula. You basically get into your chair, get on your couch, get wherever it is, load up Madden, load up the Rams playbook, the Patriots on defense, log in and play 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 and play. And what that's going to do is you're going to face several different types of defenses, several different types of schemes. And what you're going to have to do as a player of this game, if you're going to be successful, is you're going to have to learn how to basically know when to call what, know when to basically throw the ball high versus throw the ball low, know when to gamble versus when to not gamble, knowing when to run the ball versus when to pass the ball, knowing what types of fronts you're going to get pressure off the right or the left or whatever it is. Repetition is really what makes a great player. That practice Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, that's what makes champions, not Sundays. What makes champions is Monday through freaking Friday. Okay, so if I could really impart a second piece of wisdom, not just consistency, but relentless repetition in the fundamentals. I was talking to somebody today about coaching, and one of the things that they said that I thought it was such a great principle to take into consideration is even though you may have different skill levels, even though even though some players may have maybe be a really good dribbler, but other players aren't quite as good at dribbling, but they may be better at defense. You don't want to take the players that are good at dribbling and only work on defense, and you don't want to take the players who are good at defense and only work on dribbling. What you want to do is you want to consistently hone them in the basics, and they're going to, based off their skill level, they're going to take that basic drill and they're going to be able to add depth in it. It's about depth, not width, and I try to make that so clear in my channel. I'm going to give you guys the basics, I'm going to give you the fundamental plays to make you successful. What your job is to take those basics and take it to the next level, okay? So basically, what I'm trying to get you guys to see is the only way to take it to the next level is through experience, through relentless repetition, through consistency in not picking 17,000 different schemes. You want to run one playbook and you want to learn it inside and out. So important, guys. I can't stress it enough. And as you're seeing right now, my knowledge of my playbook. I know exactly where I'm going. I know exactly the situation. Two-point conversion, I'm probably going to run Y trail, or I'm probably going to run, I may run the Saint Spot Shake route. I've been working on that. Another little piece of the puzzle. I can run spacing. I got like four different plays that I can run. But you guys hopefully are understanding I have something to run. And not just that I have something to run, but I have so much repetition in it that I know when it's going to work and when it's not going to work. That's a huge, huge advantage in not just this year's game, but in really every season. This is a big, big deal. There I totally blow my responsibility. I don't even know who that is. Dotson? Must be a rookie. I've never seen that card before. But right there, that's terrible, terrible, terrible end of the half defense by me. And it's because I got aggressive. I wanted the turnover to try to, and right there, I get the ball at half. Right there, I have to be better than that. We're able to stop him, still be up one possession going into halftime, have an opportunity to come out, go up two possessions. But, no matter what, right there, I got to play better. I got to be better than that. But I hope you guys are seeing what I'm saying. It's simple. This is simple. I want to tell you a quick story about Vince Lombardi. So Vince Lombardi basically, one of the things Vince Lombardi did was he taught the basics. And so every season, what he would do is he would hold his football. He would get in front of the team for the annual team meeting or whatever. And he'd hold a football in front of his team. And he'd say, "Guys, what is this?" And they say, "Well, it's a football." And then he'd say, "Okay, and then what are we?" And he said, "Well, we're a team." And he said, "Well, what is our goal?" And they say, "Well, our goal is to win football games, to basically be the better team on the field." And he said, "Guys, here's how we're going to accomplish this. We're going to chase perfection in the fundamentals, knowing full well that we will not achieve it. But in the process of chasing perfection, we will land at excellence. If we execute the fundamentals excellently, we're going to be effective." And it really comes down to being able to consistently have solid tackling fundamentals, consistently having solid reading the defense fundamentals. I want to tell you a quick story here. This will probably help you a little bit. So I have a friend who is a former wrestling coach. And one of the things they said was that if you're trying to watch Olympic wrestling, right? Olympic wrestling, it's the most boring sport in the world, because Olympic wrestling is basically what happens is these guys are out there and the wrestlers are really just waiting for somebody to make a mistake. They're waiting for the first person to make that first mistake. And once that person makes that mistake, they're done. They lose. Whoever makes the first mistake loses. Take that concept and think about this game, right? If you've lost a game, normally it's because you've thrown a crucial interception, had a crucial fumble, maybe missed a read or two. There's several different reasons. A lot of it comes down to you not executing how you should. Normally it's not because, especially once you get to the level where you're a really solid player, normally it's not because the other player is better than you. It's because the other player out-executed you. I really, really hope you take that advice, because what happens is so often we slip in the fundamentals because we haven't practiced relentless repetition and consistency. And what happens is then we get online, we're playing or whatever, and we lose and we wonder why we lost. And really it was because we just made that mistake. We threw that interception and we threw that pick six, or we, like what I did at the end of half there, I blew a coverage assignment. All those, we can come up with reasons people lose all game, but really the bottom line is a lot of it has to do with execution. Okay, so I hope you take that piece of advice and really, really run with it, because it's so, so important. Guys, I also want to take a second here to tell you guys that I really, really hope that you guys will start asking some more questions in the comments. Whatever you want to know about Madden, just ask me. If you want to know, whatever it may be, and I can either tell you where I could point you in the right direction. Guys, I'm just trying to get across here. Bring me your questions. I need your questions because I don't know what you guys are struggling with. I can't really quite. I mean, for me, the game is pretty broken down at this point. I'm not trying to belittle you or anything. I'm just saying I need to know your struggles so that I can address them. Because for me right now, it really comes down to, really, it's all about execution. If I can out-execute someone, I feel very, very confident in my ability to win. And really, it comes down to turnovers. For me, this game, more than any other game, and I think you're going to continue to see this, it's really about who makes the first mistake. And I think you're going to continue to see this throughout. I think it's the way it is in real NFL. Who makes that first mistake? Who makes that bad read? Who rushes that throw? Here's a thought. I want to tell you a quick story, too, or really just draw off of an experience. So it's Sunday Night Football. I'm pretty sure it was 2 years ago. And Eli Manning and the Giants are on the goal line. And basically Dallas doesn't have any timeouts left in the game. It's third down and goal. And instead of running the ball, the Giants try to do a play action pass. And what happens is the play action pass isn't open. And Eli Manning's about to go down for a sack, but instead of going down for a sack, he ends up throwing the ball away. Now, what that does is it gives the Cowboys 40 extra seconds. And of course, if you guys know the story, in those 40 extra seconds, the Cowboys go down, they score a touchdown, and they're able to win the game. The reason I tell you that story is this. It was very simple. Looking in hindsight, everybody knows what Eli Manning should have done. He should have taken the sack. If he takes the sack, they probably win this game. Why didn't he do it? I'll give you two possible reasons. The first one is because he just didn't know what to do, which is very unlikely considering he's an NFL caliber quarterback. The second one I think is more likely. He did not have consistent repetition. He did not have relentless repetition in the fundamentals, how to handle that situation. It should be second nature to a quarterback in that situation to go down with the ball. Okay? The reason Eli Manning didn't do that is because he was under pressure, right? You've got three guys coming at you. Your mind just kind of goes blank and you do something stupid. What I'm trying to say is if you have that relentless repetition, your mind will second naturally know what to do. Okay? A lot of people misunderstand. A lot of it comes down to game speed and pressure. If you're able to execute under pressure and be quick at it, right, be a fast player, those things are going to speak volumes for you, okay? So I just hope that you guys consider some of the things I'm talking about in this content. If you guys agree with me, please let me know what you think. And if you don't agree with me, let me know why you disagree. I really am interested to hear if anyone doesn't agree with what I'm saying. I really would like to know why. Not because I want to argue with you. I just kind of want to hear your perspective. I think some of the most important things we can do in Madden is all around this concept of relentless repetition and consistency. So there's a second time I've been burnt deep. The first time was my fault. The second time, he just makes a great play. Yeah, it's an NFL draft card, Josh Doxson. But yeah, guys, let me know what you think. I'm trying to, constantly reevaluate, make sure I'm giving you guys content that I think is beneficial. And I really think this may be one of the most beneficial things for you guys right now, because what I think this does is it forces you guys to really, really think about how you're going to put your game plan together for next season, how you're going to put your scheme together, how you're going to put your team together, all those questions. Really, really important to wrestle with those questions early on before the game launches. If we could answer those questions before, if we could answer our practice schedule or what are some of the key things we're going to try to do better this year that we didn't do very good last season, if we can answer those questions in July and June, when August comes, we'll be ready to hit the ground running, get in the lab, find us a playbook we like, and get deep with it, get going. So those are some of the things that I would recommend doing right now. And again, I can't stress relentless repetition enough. I'm telling you, I've thrown that out route so many times. It's like literally, I don't even have to look at the screen. Okay. The Cowboys, when they were winning titles, with Troy Aikman and Michael Irvin, they would say that you know, they would go out sometimes and they'd throw the routes blindfolded. They would have it so it would be so second nature to them that they would literally be able to throw these patterns blindfolded, and it wasn't like it was just the same route over and over again. It was different routes, different timings. Michael Irvin is famous, not famous, but he's quoted saying that, you know, if him and Troy would run 10 routes, no matter what the routes were, but if they were to run 10 routes, okay, blindfolded, he believes that 8 of those 10 routes would be completed for a touchdown. I think that speaks volumes about how relentless their repetition pattern was. Okay, so that's what I'm trying to get you guys to hopefully kind of buy into here with me, is this concept again: relentless repetition is a big, big deal. Consistency and relentless repetition are two of the most important things that you can do in this game to get better. So as you're kind of thinking about what are some of the high points that you want to focus on for next season, make sure you're in practice mode, but not just in practice mode trying to find new plays. I think that's where we make the mistake. It's not that we're trying to find new plays. It's that we're trying to do what? We're trying to basically relentlessly repeat the same plays we're running over and over again, get the timing down, so then we're able to make great plays, and it's just second nature to us. Like right there, he didn't have a flat pattern. He was in a defense. He hasn't had a flat pattern out there all game. Big 4th and 15. If I don't execute there, you know, he's going to have a chance to come back and take the lead. I'm able to easily, without hesitation, you know, being able to very easily deliver the football there. Tom Brady gives me another bad pass. He's giving me a couple bad passes. And this is like a really, really good quarterback. And this specific edition of Tom Brady is a pretty, you know, pretty good quarterback. So I don't know what's going on. So there's the inside zone busting him on that inside. But I really hope you guys are kind of buying into what I'm saying. If you're not buying in, if you want to challenge it, let me know. Like, why am I wrong? Just tell me, and I'll try to listen and try to, you know, at least have some back and forth with you guys to kind of debate a little bit. But what are some of the most important things you think for getting better at this game, for getting better going in? What should we be talking about right now? What are some topics, or what are some highlights, some key points that you guys think need to be addressed in the community? Because from where I sit, I feel like it's all been addressed. I feel like right now it's about trying to get you guys to get in the gym, get in the lab, get in the practice mode, and really kind of learn, but get into it the right way. You know, don't get into practice mode because you want to find the next best blitz. Get into practice mode and run the plays that you already know work. Run them 500 times over the course of a month. You do that, then come talk to me about how good your game is. I guarantee you, if you go into practice mode and run every single one of your plays against cover 2, cover 3, cover 4, and cover 2 man, you're going to be significantly better at the end of that month. If you do it every single time you log on, if you just go into practice mode, say you have, you know, whatever, however many plays that you are really, you know, wanting to run in your scheme. So like for me, it's probably about, I don't know, we're probably sitting about 30 plays. So if I want to run 30 plays, right, and I run them, and I run each individual play in practice mode probably 4 times before I go online and actually play a game, I guarantee you my winning percentage would go up by at least 50%. Okay, this is something that I struggle with too. I don't always do it. I'm not consistent in my relentless repetition, but I'm trying to get better. And I'm telling you, looking back at this season, I think I could have been a night and day better had I put more time into relentless repetition as opposed to trying to find new plays. You know, if I would have put more of my practice mode time into basically running the plays that I already knew worked instead of trying to find new plays, I think it would have been a lot better, because it all comes down to speed. How fast do you execute? How well do you execute under pressure? And how consistent and relentless are you in your repetition? So with that stuff in mind, guys, I really, really would recommend trying that out this season. I think it would help you guys out immensely, 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 immensely. Finally, I get deep and get into where I'm supposed to be, make a big-time play. He's got a 4th and 25 coming up here. This should be pretty self-explanatory, guys. You run that 2-man under, and you say, you know, beat me. What I like to do is also spy a guy. That way, if he rolls out of the pocket, I've got him. But you'll be hard pressed to find a play that beats two men under in a 4th and 25 situation. Make that a 4th and 30 situation. But, you know, guys, if you have any questions, let me know. If you have any complaints, let me know. Like, if you have anything that you want to see, let me know. Like, I just need to kind of get your feedback and kind of hear what you guys think. I'm trying to kind of be a little bit more conceptual with my teaching, trying to show you guys some big picture stuff, stuff that's going to work every season, not just in Madden 16, but will also carry over to the next one, because the next one is right around the corner. I think August 23rd is the release date. So there we get the stop. We're up by 2 possessions. He's going to go ahead and quit out here. So, guys, I want to thank you for watching today's video. And I would ask, guys, if you enjoyed the video and you're not subscribed to the YouTube,